Welcome back to another podcast. My name is Kyle. This is episode 21. Got a different episode for you this evening. We've got CJ here. How are you, sir?
Good. Welcome to another podcast.
Yeah, welcome to the podcast.
Oh, welcome to the podcast. I thought you said another podcast.
I don't know what I said.
This is not the same one you've been listening to. This is another one.
Did I screw up the introduction?
No, the introduction's fine. Just leave it. Okay. How's it going?
Yep.
There we go.
It's going.
How's it going with you? Is that how your week's been so far?
I've been calling myself the human lawn chair recently because I'm folding under pressure.
At work?
Everywhere.
Why?
I don't know. Just overwhelmed with stuff.
Inside work and outside of work?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So I decided I'm gonna build a second server. And everything I bought for the server was wrong. RAM was wrong. Hard drive was wrong.
Are you building it off of a tower?
No. I'm building it off of an appliance. So it's called a Protectly vault. So it's got 6 Ethernet ports and then like HDMI and USB. But it's going to become a router and a server at the same time.
And what made you decide to do this?
I wanted this to do more stuff, and the operating system I'm running on that is called TrueNAS Scale. And when they first introduced it, they let you put like whatever apps you wanted on it through Docker containers and Kubernetes, and they're starting to restrict all of that. So there's applications and stuff I want to run that I can't. So I want to go with a more open operating system.
Makes sense.
So I'm going to keep this as a NAS, and eventually migrate all of the apps that I have running to the new server.
Okay.
And the new server is going to be also a router, and I'm going to replace my router that's back there because it's old and it needs to be replaced.
Okay. It makes sense.
So, yeah.
Sounds like a lot of fun.
Yeah. I needed a project to distract my brain from stuff, and that's a decent project to distract my brain. And that's what I'm going to do, but I bought everything wrong, so I have to return it all and get new stuff and...
Could be worse. Could be that you put everything together, it doesn't work.
Could be.
Yeah.
Yeah, it could be.
So.
So. How are you?
I am.
Okay.
Not will I am, but I am. Work's just been, you know, work. And I did get a new computer. They got rid of my desktop and they got me a new Windows computer. But it's small. It's like... But it's more powerful than the one I had because the one I had was already a couple of years old before I got there. So now it's like 6 or 7 years old. So this one is definitely better and it's running Windows 11.
I'm sorry to hear that.
Yeah, I know. Though I did something today I didn't expect to do.
What's that?
I funded something on, was it Indiegogo?
Mm-hmm.
It's been coming up a lot and it's something I've been looking at. And I was like, do I do it? It's a little desk robot, but you connect your phone to it.
Okay.
And the phone becomes the display. So the phone has the eyes essentially of the robot.
Mm-hmm.
It's all connected to chat GPT and all that stuff.
Cool.
And I was like, you know what? Because apparently you have to tip. I didn't know that, but the unit is going to sell. I think I got 30% or something off the unit. They're going to ship this month.
Cool.
So I was like, you know what? I'm just going to do it because I've never backed anything like this before. And I was like, why not back it? What the heck? You know? Okay. And so it was a little more money than I expected to spend because we just had someone check our backyard about finally taking care of the crack in the foundation.
Mm-hmm.
And it's going to be a little, it's not going to be as much as we expected, but it's still money to lay out.
Yeah.
And I was like, of course, the one time I go buy something, now it's like, all right, now we're going to do this.
Yep.
But
yep.
Could be worse. We actually have somebody who knows what he's talking about And he's like,
good.
He's like, I could do all this stuff and it could cost you $30,000, or I can do this, which will help you and it'll be absolutely fine and we'll fix the crack. And it's like way like under 10, even less than that.
That's good.
We haven't got it at a cost yet, so I don't even know exactly what it's going to be. But like, he wasn't pushing to do the more expensive thing.
Okay.
Which is nice.
Yeah.
You know, he didn't say you have to do this. So it's just, this house has been dealing with this for 40 years. 40 mm-hmm. years. And I just want to fix it so I don't have to like suck water out of the basement anymore.
Yeah.
Well, not me personally, the sump pump.
Right.
I stand outside with the hose going. Have you been listening to anything good? Or new, I should say. Say new.
Nothing at all. Truesdale still. That the Out of My Mind album is really good. I've been listening to that a lot.
I listened to that on Monday, actually, at work.
Yeah.
There was a few hours where I was basically by myself in the office, so I just put it on.
Nice. I did have a very strange dream last night that I thought I would talk about.
Interesting.
Yeah. So before I tell the story, there's two things you need to know about the story, or the dream. Or my life, actually, before it. So, number one, the church that I sing in the choir, that choir is starting very soon. And number two, at work, I'm about to buy a bunch of laptops. So, that'll come into play in the story. So, in the dream, this happened. So, the dogs woke up this morning at 4:30 to go to the bathroom. So, I let them out.
And, ouch.
Came back. They're starting to revert back to Greyhound time, which is they would get up at 4:30 in the morning to start their training.
Oh, really?
Yep.
That's interesting.
So I don't know why they're coming. They're every once in a while they revert back for like a couple of weeks. They're up at like 4:30 in the morning, and then they're fine again. So, anyway, so I went back to sleep like 4:30, and this is when the dream started. So, I was getting ready to go to the meeting before the first choir rehearsal to discuss like, you know, the choir stuff. I decide to go to McDonald's on the way because I'm fat and, you know, I like to have McDonald's.
And you dream about it?
I do, apparently. So it was not a normal McDonald's, though. It was a McDonald's. It was almost like at a festival. It was all outside under a tent. And there was like a counter there that you walk up to and order your food. But if you turn around, like 100, like behind you, there was a prison. And it wasn't a real prison. Like a normal prison, like it was just a fence with people inside the fence. And then there was a prison break, and the prison break was basically they opened the door to the gate and they walked out and they overtook the McDonald's, but they didn't like ransack the place. They took it over as like the inmates would go up and like order food and they would just give them food without paying. So I never got my food. And then one of my bosses at work walked up to me and goes, "So how does this affect our laptop purchase?" And then walked away. And I was like, "What?" And then I woke up.
How does that affect your laptop purchase?
Don't know.
That's interesting.
Yeah, it was quite a dream.
Oh, if anybody's listening to this and wants to help him break it down,
yep,
please send us an email because we want to break it down.
Yeah. So... Wow. I had another strange one a couple months ago. I don't remember what it was, but I told the story on the podcast, but this is a strange one too.
So. I was waiting for you to be like, yeah, so they had the prison yard and they opened up the gates and they actually were zombies.
No, they're just normal people.
Just normal people. Zombie to McDonald's. Zombie to the McDonald's.
Yeah, exactly. Zombie to the McDonald's.
McRib.
So what are we talking about tonight?
So
this was your idea.
I know. We've been doing a lot of artist spotlights, and a lot of these artists have come from hearing other artists, or like for example, Hannah Wicklund. When you first heard of her, we were both kind of finding her on Instagram and all these other things. So I thought it'd be interesting for us to share some of the musicians that we follow on Instagram or have found through social media, whether it's Instagram, Facebook. I'm mm-hmm. going to count YouTube as social media because there are interactions there, mm-hmm. And all that good stuff. So Kyle and I gathered probably 8 each, actually, of different artists that we've come across, whether they're doing a cover, whether they're doing their own stuff. And I think like mine has one person in there that's already well known, but I don't think known for the, what he can do. Meaning like he's an actor, but people don't realize how much he is a musician. And so I thought it'd be cool to just kind of play. So, we're taking them all off of YouTube. So these are all YouTube videos. We'll just be playing the audio. You're not going to put the video in the video aspect, right? No. But all of the links will be in the show notes. So if you want to watch the whole entire song or to see the artists themselves play, please check it out. But I think the ones for me, and I'm sure for Kyle, they kind of perked our interest, you know, because they were so good or so unique or whatever the case may be. So yeah, this is a little episode of people we follow on social media. Some of them are even doing more now because they have been picked up by other artists. They're playing live and stuff, but this is kind of where I found them. And I think the same thing for you, right?
Yeah. All of my artists, I first heard from YouTube.
Right. Okay.
Cause I don't do much other than YouTube social media wise. Yeah. So
cool. So wherever you want to start, cause how the lists are.
It doesn't matter to me. It's your show. So you tell me how you want me to do it, and I'll do it.
Well, I mean, I'm just looking at the list because yours is on. Why don't we just alternate? Like, would that throw you off?
No, that's fine.
If we did like one of yours, one of mine, one of yours, one of mine.
Yep.
Just to kind of balance it out.
Yep. So this first group is a group that I found on YouTube probably 15 years ago. Never heard of them before. I always thought the Canadian Brass was, you know, the brass group until I found these guys. I like them better than the Canadian Brass. These guys are a group from Vienna called the Menazel Brass. Just a fantastic group of musicians and a lot of, they're fantastic players, but there's also a lot of visual storytelling that goes along with their playing. This one, not so much. This is called At the Movies, where it's a medley of like movies and things like that. But like they have this one thing where they do like the Olympics, which is a fantastic video, and they do all sorts of crazy stuff. So anyway, this is Menazel Brass At the Movies. So they go through, they got Star Wars in there, they got Superman, they got James Bond, all sorts of movie themes in there. It's three trumpets, three trombones, and a tuba. And they're one of those groups, I know you and I had the same band director in college, and he always talked about singing your part.
Yeah.
They sing throughout this stuff. They're all great singers, and they're just a great group.
They sound more than just what they are.
They do.
They're like another group that, like, you feel like there's a lot more playing than there really is.
Yeah.
That's too funny.
So,
That's awesome.
And they're very funny. They got a lot of funny stuff.
You could tell even definitely in the plane they have a good sense of humor because of the way they like kind of at the beginning everything sounds like a mess, but it really isn't.
Yep.
Yeah.
They go into I Could Have Danced All Night, and they actually dance around.
That's awesome.
They've got to cover Bohemian Rhapsody, which is fantastic. I mean, good stuff. I can't recommend them enough.
That's great.
So
for me, the first one I chose, which we did play the duet he does with the guitarist from Polyphia on the episode with Polyphia that we did. This is Marcin, and he is a guitarist. And you probably have seen him by now, or you're starting to see him. He everything he does is on the guitar. The song that I chose was Carmen's Habanera from Habanera. The Habanera sauce.
Hanna-Barbera.
It's a song from the opera Carmen. And the reason I chose it is it's just him on the guitar. So everything you're hearing is him playing the guitar and using the guitar to its fullest capabilities, I guess is a good word for that. So
true.
Go ahead.
Some really impressive playing.
Really? And I've watched his videos multiple times, and he just, when he's playing, he goes into a trance.
Mm-hmm.
Like he just, I want to know where he goes.
Yeah.
Like he just, watch his videos, because when he plays, he just, he's shutting everything off around him.
Mm-hmm.
And it's just, it's amazing to watch him play.
Yeah.
It really is. So that's one of them. Who do you got?
Next up, I have the Newfangled Four. We talked about them, I think, season one, when we were talking about a cappella music.
Mm-hmm.
They are a barbershop quartet from California, and they've been doing some really cool stuff with barbershop stuff. The piece I chose is a cover of a Smash Mouth song, actually. Oh, I should unmute it, huh?
That would be nice.
That would be good. Let's try that again.
5 years ago we started with dreams of going far,
but we never did imagine
we'd be where we are.
To
sing on shows around the world is such a dream come true.
And if
these four losers can do all that, so can you.
So can you.
This barbershop quartet gets on stage. You won't believe what happens next.
Somebody once told me the world was gonna roll me. I ain't the sharpest tool in the shade. She was looking kinda dumb with her finger and her thumb in the shape of an L on her forehead. Start coming and they don't stop coming. Fed to the rules and I hit the ground running. Didn't make sense not to live for fun. Your brain gets smart but your head gets dumb. So much to do, so much to see. So what's wrong with taking the back streets? You'll never know if you don't go.
No, you'll never shine if you don't glow.
So hey now, you're an all-star. Get your game on, go play. Hey now, you're a rock star. Get the show on, get paid. All that glitters is gold. Only shooting stars break the mold.
The stage is a cool place and it never gets old.
I left the introduction in because I think it does something that social media does a lot, where it kind of baits you into the whole thing and the whole, you know, a barbershop, you know, quartet gets on stage, you'll never believe what happens next, that clickbait kind
right,
of feel.
Right.
You know, that's huge in social media. It's how they get all their views. So
that's awesome.
That's why I left that in.
That was good. That was good. Yeah. All right. So I chose She's a Harpist. Her name is Kristan Toksko. She's from the Netherlands, I think. And, oh, it says she's a Canadian artist, but I think she lives in the Netherlands now. Anyway, that's not the important part. The important part is her ability to play the harp. And I found her on Instagram. You know, I happened to be looking at a musician and hers came up, a video of hers came up. And she was playing, I think she was playing Metallica on the harp. So she has a regular harp and she has an electric harp. So this song, actually, the one I chose is the Rolling Stones' Painted Black, her cover. And she just had an album come out in February called Rock Echoes, and all of them are rock songs. Everything from Sweet Child of Mine, Painted Black, Love of My Life, from Queen, Wish You Were Here, Pink Floyd. So very interesting. So this is Painted Black by Kristan Toksko. I hope I said the name right.
Songs that you never thought you'd hear played on a harp,
right? And you never think that it would sound actually nice on a harp.
Yeah,
like her arrangement's very pretty.
Yeah.
So I want to check out her album now. I want to listen to the whole thing. So,
so for me next, I have a group called Pomplemousse. This is a group with Jack Conti, who is one of the co-founders of Patreon. I've never been a huge fan of their stuff, but this one kind of caught my eye when I found it on social media, on YouTube. And this features a band called Lawrence singing as well. So this is Me and Julio down by the schoolyard. And I need to unmute it again. I forget when I close the window and open it up again, it doesn't unmute. So I'll get it. I promise.
Yeah.
Say Me and Julio. Yeah,
yeah, see.
Seeing me and Julio down by the schoolyard. Seeing me and Julio down by the schoolyard. Well, Mama Pajama rolled out of bed and she ran to the police station. And when the papa found out and began to shout, he started the investigation. It's against the law. It was against the law. What that mama saw. It was against the law. And mama looked down and spit on the ground every time her name gets mentioned. And papa said, oh, if I get that boy, I'm gonna stick him in the house of detention. Well, I'm on my way. I don't know where I'm going. I'm on my way. I'm taking my time, but I don't know where. Goodbye, oh, who's he? The queen of Corona. Seeing me and Julio down by the schoolyard. Seeing me and Julio down by the schoolyard. Woo!
So, yeah, and that's just a whole bunch of them just sitting in a room together playing.
That's fun. So, that was fun.
Yeah.
The next person I chose, his name is Luca Strigaconini. I have these the plastic retainers in my mouth, and I can't say it. My Italian, it's horrible right now. Strigagnoli. Forgive me for butchering the Italian because of these plastic retainers. Came across him on YouTube, actually, and the video I saw, he actually had a guitar designed. It actually has three necks to it, but it's an acoustic guitar, and he's got, I think he's got 2 6 strings on there, and then he's got another bar, and I forget what it was for, but he does a cover of Eminem's Lose Yourself.
Interesting.
Yeah, so I had it's very impressive.
Cool. Well, let us check it out once it loads. A really big hand.
He does. But he's another one who uses the whole guitar.
Yep.
And it's just, it's brilliant. He plays very well. I that three necked guitar that he had created, I have to check it out more.
Yeah. Wow. And he actually gives credit to Stevie Wonder for Gangster's Paradise, which I like.
Yes.
Oh, I lost my mouse. Hang on. There's my mouse. So I just realized that I have my windows open, and there has been a cicada like screaming at the top of its lungs for the first 30 minutes of this recording. So it just stopped, which is why I noticed it.
But I didn't hear it.
You didn't hear? Oh, because Zoom probably filtered it out.
That's possible, yes.
So, all right, coming up next, this is a bunch of musicians. This is Josh Turner and Reina Del Cid and a bunch of other musicians. This is a cover of Blackwater by the Doobie Brothers. And this is, the cicada's coming back. Mm-hmm. They're sitting in their tour bus and they're just recording this, which is kind of cool. And I think the night before they had done a rehearsal. If you watch the video all the way through, you can see the rehearsal, them planning out the recording in the Czech Republic. So,
oh, that's cool.
This is Doobie Brothers, Blackwater.
Rolling video take 8. Blackwater.
Well, I build me a raft and she's ready for floating. Oh, Mississippi, she's calling my name. Catfish are jumping, that paddle with thumping. Black water keep rolling on past just the same.
Oh, black water, keep on rolling.
Mississippi moon, won't you keep on shining on me?
Oh, black water, keep on rolling.
Mississippi moon, won't you keep on shining on me?
Oh, black water, keep on rolling.
Mississippi moon, won't you keep on shining on me?
And keep on shining your light. I'm gonna make everything pretty, mama. Gonna make everything alright.
And I ain't got no worries, 'cause I ain't in no hurry.
And what's really cool is that they, you know, Reina Del Cid also has a very big YouTube presence as well. So they both kind of, they're the two biggest presences as far as I'm concerned on YouTube. So Reina and Josh Turner. So just kind of cool. They both kind of joined together to do a YouTube video. So.
Sounded good too.
And Josh also plays a lot with Mary Spender. I'm a huge Mary Spender fan. And it was hard for me not to get a Mary Spender in there, but I like her stuff a lot.
That's too funny.
So
we've been playing a bunch. We played Billy Strings. We have some Billy Strings coming up. We played him. That was, yes. So banjo got into the bluegrass. So this is a group called, the group is Seth Mulder and Midnight Run. I don't know if you've heard of them at all. But
I've heard of Seth Mulder. I don't know Midnight Run.
There's Seth Mulder's in it. Colton Powers is in it. Max Silverstein is in it. Tyler Griffith is in it. Chevy Watson is in it. And they're basically a bluegrass banjo group. And I just thought they sounded really great together. I couldn't find the one that I wanted, which was basically like Seth Mulder on the mandolin playing like a rock song real quick and then going into the song. But this is their song, One More Night.
She left me without notice. She had no reason that I'm sure. She left her home and little family, and now this pain I must endure. I can't bear to see another evening come. sleep. One more night to dream about her, and one more night for me to weep. Evening come, one more night to lose some sleep, one more night to dream about her, and one more night for me to weep.
Very cool.
They're fun, but I love it. It's very it's more rooted in bluegrass than some of the other stuff we've heard.
Yep, for sure. All right, I need to jump ahead a little bit in this video. Okay, good. So the next one is Miles Kennedy. Miles Kennedy, I found on YouTube, and I know he's got a decent following with Alter Bridge, and he did the Sound of Silence with Disturbed. But this was the first time I had heard Miles Kennedy sing. And then I found his song Watch Over You, which is unbelievably good. But this is him covering an Elton John song called Leave On. It's just him on the acoustic guitar.
And, so I'm going to give this song a try. This is called Leave On.
Leave On wears his wounds like a crown. He calls his child Jesus because he likes the name, and he sends him to the finest schools in town. Leave On, Leave On likes his money. Makes a lot, they say. Spends his days counting in a garage by the motorway. He was born a pauper to a pawn on a Christmas day. Times that God is dead and the war on. Alvin Toffling had a son today. And it shall be a leave on, and it shall be a good man, and it shall be a leave on in tradition with the family plan. And it shall be leave on, and it shall be a good man. He shall be leave on. Yeah.
He plays a lot with Slash as well, and his vocal range is just ridiculous.
I'm sure. It sounds like it is.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right. So, the next person that I have is Mohini Day. She was born in Mumbai, India. Okay, but she plays the bass, a five-string bass to be exact. She does rock, funk, jazz, and metal. But she also incorporates her Indian heritage into some of her playing. So the song that she's doing, she's playing is Meat Eater, which is she's playing slap bass, and I did it just because of the technicality that she plays on the instrument for the song. But I saw she plays a video of her, and I don't know who's singing with her, but they're doing an Indian song, and she just plays the bass beautifully next to the voice. Like, so she's very, very talented. and I found her on Instagram, and I just think she's really, really talented, and I'm hoping for good things for her.
Cool. Oh, sorry.
It's okay.
I hit the wrong button. Sorry, I cut off the end.
Oh, no.
Oh, no.
It's okay.
Okay.
No worries. But, like, she's fast, too.
Yeah, she is.
And she's only 28 years old. She's young. And she's crazy talented. I think I've been following her on Instagram for about a year. And I didn't realize extensively how much she's doing. And I think it's great. And I hope she's out there. She gets out there more, you know.
Yeah.
It looks like her father has been in movies, or he's done music for movies. Oh, visual effects. He's a visual effects person. Okay, that's what it is. So he did visual effects for like the movie Flatliners, Glass Onion. So like a few pretty well known movies. You know.
Interesting.
So, which is very cool. But yeah, and she's got a really awesome wolf tattoo on her right arm. That's actually a wolf that transitions into a bass neck.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah, it was actually, I just saw it. It's very cool. So yeah, really, really talented bassist, and I hope to see and hear more from her.
Very cool. I'm gonna sneak one in because you made me think of another one.
Okay.
And I thought this was an interesting one. So this is another Indian artist, and she was found by Victor Wooten through social media.
Oh, that's right. Yes.
And this is the video that he found her on. This is Vairi Joshri. She is an Indian singer, and he found this video of her singing over Giant Steps. I thought it would be just kind of interesting to listen to some that, you know, he found this.
Right. Absolutely. YouTube,
so. So before she became discovered, her YouTube channel was basically her singing John Coltrane tunes.
Who is this again?
Vairi Joshri.
And the name. I knew you. I couldn't, because I just found out that the bassist's mother is a singer. And, you know, so I wasn't sure if it was like relationship or whatever. But she's got a crazy voice.
Yeah, she does.
And just what she did is amazing.
Yeah.
It's pretty awesome. Good fill-in.
Yeah.
Who you got next, though, on your list?
Oh, I'm going to go again. All right, cool.
Yeah, go ahead. No, just, I figured, yeah.
Okay. So this is Carrie Ellis. Carrie Ellis is, she was in Broadway for a while, and did Wicked. And Brian May found her, and Brian May of the Queen fame. And this is in Brian May's studio. This is Brian May playing Defying Gravity with Carrie Ellis.
else's game. Too late for a second guessing. Too late to go back to sleep. It's time to trust my instincts. Close my eyes and leave. It's time to someone says they're so. Some things I cannot change, but till I try, I'll never know. Too long I've been afraid of losing love, I guess I've lost. Well, if that's love, it comes at much too high a cost. I'd sooner buy defying gravity.
And songs like this are I think are really difficult because they're, you know, they became popular. Like this one with Idina Menzel, it was so big and so popular, like trying to like do something with it is hard to do. And I think she does the song justice.
Oh, they do. She does. And it's very cool how they put more rock behind it and make it a little bit more grittier than what it is. So that's very cool. Yep. That was, I think you showed that to me once before.
Yeah, I think I did.
Yeah. Wow, totally worth it. Such a good one. Okay, so next one, we know this person as an actor, Joseph Gordon-Levitt. Now, he has a group called Hit Record, right? Or a company, Hit Record. He's a musician. So he was just in the most recent Beverly Hills movie, which focused on Eddie Murphy's character that's part of Netflix. All right. And he did the Beverly Hills Cop theme remix. So every one of the instruments in this video are played by him. So cool. I don't think we realize how talented he is. Some people probably do, but this video really, I think, shows how talented and capable he is.
Okay. So the title of that one hurts my brain a lot.
Why?
Want to stay in the know about your favorite Netflix shows and movies?
Hey, Netflix.
We're not sponsored. We're not sponsored.
Not sponsored. Not sponsored. So the title of that one hurts my brain a lot because when I hear Joseph Gordon-Levitt, I think Jennifer Love Hewitt.
Yes.
And when I see Beverly Hills Cop, I think Beverly Hills Ninja with Chris Farley. So trying to keep all that straight in my stupid brain is very hard.
That's
for
actually
me,
pretty
so.
Funny. But like, I love what he brings to Kazooin.
Yeah.
But he's talented, you know.
Yeah.
I really give him a lot of credit. I think it was a very cool mashup, and to do it for the show. So I had to just I had to share that because that came up. I was flipping through and like he came up, was like, oh, that's just too good. That's too good not to show.
All right, Todrick Hall, fantastic singer, fantastic artist in general, did a version of The Wizard of Oz with a group called Pentatonix, which I'm sure most people have
heard. Who's that?
I know. And speaking of YouTube, you know, stuff and
very
social media, like there, that's, you know, that's how they made it big is, well, that and the sing off. But this is Todrick Hall called The Wizard of Oz, and Oz is A-H-H-H-S. So it's kind of a compressed version of The Wizard of Oz. all a cappella. So they stick in a whole lot of, you know, other songs and to help tell the story, which is just kind of neat. So.
That's awesome. All right.
What you got next?
So the guy that we have next, his name is Adam Ben Ezra. He is from Israel, Tel Aviv Yafo. I didn't realize. I don't know how that works. I thought there was just Tel Aviv, but maybe there's like. But anyway, that's neither here nor there. 41-year-old self-taught multi-instrumentalist. And another one who uses the full bass fiddle, because he plays bass fiddle, but he also plays piano. I don't know what this one's called. It's OUD, oid.
An oud.
An oud? Is it an oud?
Oud.
Okay. Yep. A cajon, a guitar, a bass guitar, clarinet, and flute.
Cool.
So he's pretty out there. This song is done with a gentleman featuring Michael Oliveira. And it's off of a new album that's coming up, and the name of the song is called Cosmic Nomad. Gave me a little bit of like Cosmic Hippo.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, I can see that. And a little bit of Stanley Clarke in there.
Yeah. Yeah, I think he's influenced definitely, but definitely. I think it's very cool. They're very interesting. So What do you got? This is your last one, right?
Last one. I think we played this one at one point. I don't remember when. I remember talking about it. But this is a cover of Africa by a gentleman by the name of Mike Massey and his bassist, Jeff Hall. This is done in like a little pizza shop. And his voice still surprises me because when you look at him, you don't look like, it doesn't look like he's got this voice behind him, but it always surprised me every time they sang. So this is Africa by Mike Massey. Live at the Pie Pizzeria in Utah.
Echoing tonight, she hears only whispers of some quiet conversation. She's coming in 12:30 flight. The moonlit winds reflect the stars that guide me toward salvation. I stopped an old man along the way, hoping to find some old forgotten words or ancient melody. He turned to me as if to say, "Hurry, boy, it's waiting there for you. It's gonna take a lot to drag me away from you. There's nothing that a commitment or more could ever do.
He does not look like he has a tenor voice like that. It's, you know.
I know. I remember when you first showed me that video, I was just, and they're good together, those two guys.
Yeah, they
their
are.
Voices are really yeah. good together. Especially yeah. when the guy comes in with the harmony, you're just like, okay, mm-hmm. yep, they yep. know what they're doing. Like, it was yep. just really good. All right. The last one that I have, I follow a gentleman named Giacomo Tura, and he plays guitar. He plays a bunch of different instruments, and he works with the guy Daniel Fasano. But they do a cover of "Virtual Insanity" with Phoebe Caddis and Alex Castro, which I believe they are a couple, like they're married. So it was just a cool cover. So I thought it would be fun to play.
And for those of you that saw the funny face I was making, I didn't see the first name on the list, so I thought there was something wrong. So
no, it's just it's not up strange. There because it's his YouTube channel and they're playing with him. Yeah.
Yep. Okay.
Never give.
So I guess the moral of the story of tonight's episode is, as much as I complain about social media, it's really not that bad.
Well, we've said that. We said that.
Yeah, but I still complain about it.
Listen, there's a lot of negatives to it, mm-hmm. but I think this is one of the positives.
Yeah.
This is a big positive. I mean, and not just music, like visual mm-hmm. artists,
yeah,
video artists, graphic designers, like that's mm-hmm. that's social media. It's such a great yeah. tool for them to be seen and heard. I mean, like you just said, Victor Wooten found that singer
yep.
from watching a YouTube video.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's just, you never know.
Yep.
Yeah. She's got a great voice.
Yeah, she does.
Yeah. So that was a fun episode.
That was a lot of fun.
Yeah. I don't know what we're doing next week because we're supposed to do an interview, but I don't know if it's going to work out yet.
Okay. Do you have any honorable mentions?
I don't.
Okay.
I don't, because these were the ones that stuck out and I just wanted to make sure they were on the list. So I don't really don't have. Okay. I forget what the name of her band is. There is an actress that was on a show that I watched, and she on the show she played guitar and stuff like that, but she now does strictly music and very rock, very classic rock. And I can't remember the name of the band.
Okay.
Why, do you have one?
I would say Mary Spender is up there for me. There are a couple. I mean, the King Singers, they do a lot of really cool stuff. Right. Home Free's done a lot of really cool stuff.
Yes.
Voice Play's done some really cool stuff.
I mean, we could continue this into the next episode.
Yeah, I mean, we could. I mean, there's... and then I found... Let me see if I can find it really quickly. Hang on. I found something really cool today on Instagram, actually, which is not normally where I get my music stuff. Where was it? Here it is. I'm just going to play it because it's so much fun.
Bluey!
So that's the Melbourne Symphony Orchestra playing the Bluey theme song. They do the Keepy Uppy song, and they have a cartoon a balloon that they hit to each other throughout the whole thing. Then they do the Grannies thing, and they have people dressed up as the Grannies while they're playing.
So it's basically like Bluey in concert.
Yeah, it's hysterical. It's really that's well awesome. Done, and just, you know.
And the music in that show is phenomenal.
Oh, it sure is.
And they the fact that they play so many classical tunes too.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yep.
Which is back in the day, that's what they did. They used classical yeah. music to drive the show, mm-hmm. and yep. they're going back to it with Bluey, and mm-hmm. it's very cool.
Yeah, it's very clearly done by someone who's our age.
Yes, it totally is.
For sure. I mean,
yep.
So, all right, I'm done now.
Join Kyle Friday night at 8:00 live on Twitch at Eastern Standard Time. Join us Sunday at 7:30 Eastern Standard Time. We'll probably play most of these songs in full versions and anything else that we feel they've done that we feel, you know, should be played as well.
Yep.
And just hit that link. Check out these YouTube videos. That's the more important thing. Those people are mm-hmm. definitely worth a watch.
Yep. Give them a follow. And make sure when you watch the video, like them and subscribe to them, because yes. it does help out their channel a
yes.
lot.
Yes.
You know, and share them. Those are the big things. You know, the liking thing is huge for the algorithm. Commenting on the video is huge for the algorithm. So
yes.
that helps them. So just, you know, do them that favor.
You can do that for us too. But more importantly, the musicians, we want them to grow. We yeah. want them to keep doing and making music.
I think I'm done.
I got nothing else.
All right. Thank you all for listening, and we'll see you next week. Thanks for listening to the Turn on the Music podcast. Make sure you check our link tree in the show notes for our social media accounts. If you like what you heard, please share it with a friend. And we'd love it if you could give us a 5-star rating on your platform of choice. We'll see you next week. And remember, always share the music.